We can go to war with these guys now, right? Yeah, we can. We just wait for the cavalry to arrive. There's no supplies for the damn cavalry. That's a shame. Hang on. Can I see where the better supply regions are? Don't want to go straight in. Oh, hang on. I've got a much better idea than this. Bring him over to here. Let them resupply. And we just go for it. Everywhere they go through, the state becomes much worse supplied. Screw it. I'm going to kick this off now. Hang on. Declare war. Puppet. Oh, yeah. Puppet. Send. We're going. And the cavalry, when it arrives, can kick off there somewhere later. God, everyone's attacking everyone by the looks of this. This is mental. It has arrived. It's immediately under attack. Which means that we can probably push quite hard into it. Hang on, we should change that to like full priority for these guys. Just pull back a bit, because these massive divisions here, these should be like powering in now. I'll just wait for the cavalry to recover organization. Join wars. Keep these guys out if we can. Oh, what was the US one? Crap, the US one popped up and it shouldn't have done. And I clicked it off by accident. Okay, so we've got some better guns. We're in 1940. We're going to go for some improved air defenses. And how are... Okay, these still haven't finished. That was a slow going. And I've started a possibly unwise war down here. But I think we can get in. Well, we're making some progress. We have military factories, which we've got trucks in abundance at last. The AA, let's do that. And let's put the planes up by one. We must have captured some. That must be where all this has come from. And support equipment by two. We'll put two into there. We've still got more. Superb. That's it. Nice. That's going to increase our need for aluminium, steel and stuff, etc. We should have all the aluminium and steel we need after conquering these scumbags. Right, we're going straight for that bit. You guys are going straight for that bit. This is why I like using big blocks of divisions. We just power our way through. If only I had some... tanks or something. But that's a nice looking number. Everything green. Our yellow army's going to get smashed a little bit. Oh, I should have tried to unlock their military code, shouldn't I? But never mind. It's too late for that. What have we got? We've got a new army coming on. Brilliant. I'll not do anything with them just yet. Are we going in? We're going in. Right, 12 divisions. Straight into Gangsu. Hangzhou. However it's pronounced. Right, get this side of the river. Where did the cavalry go? Cavalry's going across there at the moment. The cavalry. Nice. Improved artillery. That is going to be a nice bonus. We want... We're in 1940. Anything in there? We can't switch to mechanized stuff. That's like a, it's like a distant goal, just a dream at the moment. But things are going to start coming on very quickly now. Let's go for. I guess we're going to go for this excavation. We're doing all right. Right, where's the cavalry? Is the cavalry in now? Because the infantry can easily deal with that. Soviet Union's gone to war with Finland. Right, we bring these guys over here. And we're just making a rush for the capital. We need to try and get that to collapse. It's funny that there's nothing up there. Do we have... We have 17 divisions in a brand new army over here. Well, we're going to give them a bit of a brutal awakening. But we're going to bring them in. Do you know what? I don't care if we lose the goals on these other dudes to start with, because we've got a year to try and conquer them. But they don't have any resources. I mean, having puppets is always useful. Use their manpower, for example. But we can probably live without them. But this one was really worth taking because resources. Right, those guys are in. Get across there. Let's link up with Hong Kong. We have a land border with the UK. Does that mean we can get the steel and stuff from them? We've got the hump. That should give us a military factory. And this would give us... right, nice. That would actually give us the better airframes, or the chance to research one. Advanced small airframe. Chinese Expeditionary Force. What does this do? It's not in a civil war. It gets a new general for China. We might do that. Whereas this one gives us another military factory. Well, I mean, we're going to be going with all of them, so let's go for it. Right, the cavalry's kind of getting bogged down there. It's not making it in. Crunch! Let's try and, like, put some guys off there. Yeah, come on. Come on, dudes. You've got to get in. If we cut this off, then that little pocket can easily fall. Better equipment. I like it when things kick off. Keeps it interesting. Right, so we were looking for... Okay, so that research bonus is for the advanced small airframe. It's not for this one. So that's good to know. So there's no rush to get that like I thought there might have been. In the naval stuff, I did actually want to make sure we've got submarines researched. I can get early subs. I kind of want this. Because I want to try building some mine submarines. But I guess it's not urgent priority, is it? However, we're at a state where there's not an awful lot else that really is pressing. Apart from that, okay, I'll get excavation because that will allow us to develop the, what do you call it? Aluminium resources. Join wars. Yeah, go on then, accept. Oh God, I should have clicked accept. Yeah, bring them on. Bring them on. Everyone's joining the wars now. You guys need to join that force. Nope, not that one. That one. Who are currently engaged down here. Bring them down. Whoops. It's all these ones that aren't fighting somewhere. These ones, I think. Bring them in. I mean, we're making progress now, so this is looking a bit healthier. The cavalry's trying to get across there. It wants to be going into there. That's where it wants to be going. Hungary joined the Axis. I think, yeah, they're going across there. That's going to fail. Let's just make sure we marmalize that. And then Macau is actually Portuguese. You can't tell, but because of the color, but it is. And we will temporarily not recruit any more troops until we've got this business sorted out. Right, nice. 7 divisions have just arrived. What do we want to do? We want to try and cut these off everywhere. Let's go into there. put those two off. It's kind of working. We've got more military factories. We're going to lose all these military factories in a bit, so I will not put them in because we'll have to reassign everything. The reason we're going to lose them is because this is going to, I'm going to puppet this area, which means I can get the resources for just like a really bargain deal. I think that's going to be the way to do the things. Right, do we have any pressing things to spend this on? Counter-infiltration sweep is always good. We can integrate their army. I don't think I want to do that. There's nothing desperate there, so if I go and look in this, what have we got options for? Tank designer, chief of the navy, a military high command, the army logistics expert. Okay, I'm going to finally put that guy in. Oh, we've got a cavalry specialist. Yeah, go on then. Thought he was already in that role, but I guess not. You see, I mean, the amount of time I spent playing this game, there are still elements to it where I just don't understand how it works. Right, let's bring those up there. I don't fancy battering my way across that. So we're going to try and sneak our way across here. And then we're going to go across there. And that does put us in range of going straight for the capital. Right, let's have half of these guys. We need to mop this up just so we can bring troops across. And we need to watch that Japan doesn't sneakily come in and then start occupying the ports. So that is worth watching for. Right, those guys have just been crushed, which is excellent. Seven divisions. Let's go down there, push that. These should all start starving horribly in there before long. I might have to redraw some of these defense lines because they're getting a bit silly. Yeah, hang on. Let's just put pause on that. Get the yellow army. And put this on. And this line does not need to follow all that. It can go there. There you go. We've got two distinct lines again. That's fine. That's better. That's much better. We should be getting lots of experience from this. We want to have a little glance over at Europe at the moment. Vichy, France, Italy, United Kingdom. Is Italy not at war? They certainly are. We can't see what's going on. German Reich has settled that bit. Okay. Well, one day we might have the German Reich on our doorstep, depending on what happens with the Soviet Union. So we've got to bear that in mind. And what's the situation with the infantry equipment? All right, it's building up. So before long, we'll be able to go and root out some more communists. God, this is a mess. Where did the cavalry go? The cavalry's in. Excellent. Yeehaw! Bring it in. Oh God, it's cut off. Hang on, we don't need that. Right, okay. We do need the cavalry to not be cut off and starving to death here. Because that is quite the disaster. Drippy. Come on, we're going to try and cut across with everything we've got to try and get over here. Yeah, this is looking a lot more wholesome. Let's just move that force over there. That is the way to do it. We'll swap them all, and we'll have to leave a few defenders at that place. Let's see. Dare I do this? I guess we leave one behind all the way, just to try and leave this corridor open. We need the capital. It's just the capital. Do you know what? I'm going to send someone just over there. We're just going to go for a mad dash. Leave one guy here. And let's see if we can get that cut off. Because that looks like a super opportunity there. So this is slowly coming around to me. Yep, join the wars. If they can come and help, I don't know if that means they get to pick bits of lab, but I don't think they'll have done enough to have earned a war score in this. If I'm wrong about that and I don't get to puppet all of this, well, there'll be more wars kicking off. That's for sure. Hang on a sec. Just finish this guy off here. This should be finished fairly soon as divisions push in. I mean, there's a lot of divisions caught in there. We've got the capital, which is excellent. They've only really got that big port down there left. Nice. New anti-aircraft guns. We're in July 1940. Let's look over here. Okay, that's all going as planned. I'm wondering if I should actually start working up a tank industry, because we could potentially start developing that. Plus, I can't think of anything majorly else to... Oh, well, yes, I can, actually. Let us go for engines and stuff like that. We're going to go for self-sealing fuel tanks to make our fighters a bit better. So, towed anti-air. Go through anti-air. Situation with resources is bad for the moment, but it's okay. We're going to fix that. Right, it looks like this is going to finally kick off. Right, good. That's looking good. Make sure we pause. I want to have a look at this. So these guys are about to... Right, they're about to crumble. We'll just make sure the cavalry sits in there. And we'll just bring up some cavalry here to make sure our corridor stays open. But holding on to their capital, we should be fine. Right, they're cut off. That's not good. Do that. And hopefully the cavalry can sit there for quite some time. Out of supply, I hope. Can you guys please try and just crush everything down here? Come on. Are you fighting? No, don't do that. Go that way through. Right, I may have made a bit of a risk here. We're going to take one and see if we can link up with the forces up there. Where was that other force? Didn't I have another big division? Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay, well, we have troops in the area. We need to get this fight finished down here as fast as possible. It shouldn't go on much longer. I mean, look at it. Right, I need another victory point location. What have we got? It would be this one, wouldn't it? I mean, they're crumbling fast. How about I rapidly take... Oh, these guys can get medals as well. Nice. Go on, then. We're going to try and do this. And hopefully there's nothing down there. There's a victory location here, and they've got 10 bloody divisions in the mountains there. Because, of course, they have. Right, that's not going to hold there. They've got stuff here. Interesting. I hadn't appreciated that. Well, you guys just make sure you wipe that out. We've got Lido Road, which does give us a free military factory, which is nice. And the modern logistics gives us a bonus for researching a whole load of stuff. So I think we keep that. That one. Research bonus for a reconnaissance company and airborne company. We're going for this. Right, so we nip across over here again. United States, they're fine. United Kingdom are starting to drop a bit, so we improve relations. We just keep that high because we can't afford to like drop that at all. Come on then, can we please try and break into this? And finish all these guys off. I've got three cavalry divisions here, look. This isn't part of the deal. Yes. Nice. Excellent. So we get loads of stuff. They've capitulated. I'm glad that stopped then. We can quickly get our troops back up north. So, I don't know how to pronounce this, actually. I don't want to take them. If I select all, how do I puppet these? Liberate puppet. Puppet the gang secretly. I should be able to do this, right? Submit demands. And are we done now? I think we're done now. Pass. There's nothing else to do. Confirm an exit. We're done. No. I selected puppet, didn't I? I'm sure I selected puppet. Unless I selected the other thing first. Crap. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to puppet them so we get all this in a much simpler fashion. Well, it is what it is. It's done. I must have selected it in the wrong order. It wouldn't be one of my playthroughs without making a major blunder. Anyway, you guys are now free to come back up here. We still get the resources. I think we only get half the resources as opposed to the full amount. So anyway, there's some sort of Japanese thing kicking off up here. So we get everyone on the trains up here quickly. We bring these up as well. Oh, actually, you can come up this way instead. We get this mess sorted out. Luckily, the Japanese are not in a state to do anything at all, looking at this. This is awesome. We can just go walking in here, actually. We've lost some of the forces up there. We need to be aware of that. Right, we need to have just a sit down and a cup of tea and think about this for a minute. Right, so halt those. We need to have 1, 2, 3, 4. I might as well put 5, 6, 7, 8. I might as well have some strong forces defending these ports, eh? There's no point not. And the only other port is this one here, so.
Shoulda, jump away.
So let's put those guys in there, and I don't think there's anything else down there. We'll have some spare troops, and I'm going to work out what to do with those in just a minute. Right, we've also got, let's see what we've got now. Utilize domestic film industry. We gain base war support plus 10. We're quite high on that, actually. That's surprisingly high. There's war bonds, which helps with consumer goods factories. That's quite good. We can expand the Lito Road, so this will. It does what? What is it? July 1940. I need to see who else we're going to kick out next. This was increase the airlift over the hump. It uses a couple of civilian factories, but we get air bases and an off-map artillery factory. Okay. I think I'll do that. That looks like a bonus one to do. Is anything else down here? Yes, this communist infiltration in Beijing. Let's go and knock those guys out. Take national leadership. So, what does this do? All Chinese countries have access to this decision to initiate the power struggle. Communist China has to complete coalition government. The warlords have to complete join the Republican government. All Chinese countries have access to this decision to initiate the power struggle. Communist China has to complete coalition government. And the warlords have to complete join the Republican government. Okay. I have no idea if that's something that I want to be worried about, but we've got 143 points. We might just hold off that on a moment. Right, so we do have military factories. This is good news. Well, I mean, this is good news. Trade. How are we doing for trade? We need aluminium and rubber. I'm surprised we're not extracting a little. I thought we were getting aluminium from this deal. No, we've got a load of tungsten. Quite a bit more steel now, so we can reduce our dependence on... We still can't... Well, hang on. Can we get steel from the UK now? No. We're still getting it from Vichy France. I'd rather get it from anyone else, but we can reduce it because we've got, like, too much coming in. So that's... Hang on. We won't have it in a minute. I'll do this in the right order. We need to go to the factories and set production off. So we're going to have plenty of infantry equipment. It's now time to go and research some submarines because we can eventually get that started. The aircraft are building slowly. We're going to get some rubber and some aluminium, so that's okay. The trains are just building up. The trucks are building up nicely. In fact, we could almost afford to reduce that. We will need a load of those later, though. We are going to need something in there, and we're going to need a couple in artillery because artillery are going to be a big thing for us. I'm going to put more trucks in, and wow, we really did get some factories there, didn't we? Well, let's build this up. This place must have been absolutely loaded with factories. I'm going to have a real issue with this, though, aren't I? I need 20 aluminium. Right, so give me for trade. I'm going to leave that for a minute. So I'm going to loot... Oh, actually, how many civilian factories have we got? Yeah, we didn't get a lot of civilian factories out of this deal. So we're going to trade some of these away for 3 aluminium from... It's going to have to be Vichy France again. We're getting a lot of stuff from them. And rubber. We can get this from British Malaya, so this is fine. And we wanted... How many did we want? We just want one. It's a bad deal to get two. So now we can get producing aircraft at a better rate. Anyway, in the meantime, I kind of think that I better go and deal with the situation. We've got another one breaking out here. We have another army for this job. We have these guys. Who are just going to arrive on the coast over here.
Chuba!
And then kick his ass. Right, we've got troops arriving up here, which is great. The aircraft situation, has it got any better? 50. We should be able to start reinforcing that now. Cavalry has turned up, all 10 of them. Let's see, where am I going to... base this initial attack. We're going to put them up here. And we're going to put these off because these also look like the weakest.
Yes,
24 divisions. Let's make sure we're across the river. Should be a fairly simple chop-up job, this. And who should we put in our government now? We can't modify that yet, but we're not far off. We could put a chief of the navy in. This might be a bit of a problem. The current max is 110. I kind of want to save that if we can. We can add a theorist. A military theorist. Land doctrine cost is reduced. If we're going to do anything, what about a ship designer? Coastal defense fleet. So the production cost is... Oh, max range of everything is reduced, but I can't see that we need a massive max range, do we? There you go, shipyard raiding fleet. So the capital ships, we're not going to build any capital ships. Everything else looks really good. So yeah, let's put him in.